China's Z-millennials grew up with social media. This digital era helped shape their attitudes and lifestyles. Yumin Chen is an associate professor of Chinese at St. Mary's College in the U.S. state of Maryland. She says this change in culture is reflected in consumer habits.
So unlike their parents' generation, because usually we would think Chinese people are more thrifty in terms of spending and budgeting, and also they are worried about the future. They tend to spend less to save for the future. Whereas this generation, because they grew up in a more stable and, you know, socioeconomically wise, more stable society, and then the economy is growing, prospering. So they are growing up in a family that their parents were more educated and then more wealthy. And also China has this one child policies in the 80s. So they are like the only sole kids, you know, they are all of them are like the queens and kings in the family, but parents, grandparents, they all pamper them, spoil them. So they grew up in an environment that's wealthy, you know, relatively wealthy. So they don't have this mindset about worrying about the future. And so the Z generation, they started to have this habit of, you know, pampering themselves. They are willing to invest themselves more, unlike the previous generations.
And where are they getting their money? Are their parents allowing this? And what is it about their parents' generation that is allowing their children to spend more money on themselves?
Because they are the only kids, so the grandparents from both sides, they're willing, and also the parents, they all want to invest their money on the education, you know, on the clothing, on, you know, overall, you know, environment. Parents are willing to give them like more allowance and pocket money.
So what are they wanting to buy? There's been a rise in spending on luxury goods in China. Tell us about what Generation Z wants.
Okay, I think one of the features that Generation Z has is that they value individualities, right? And then they actually travel extensively. Unlike the previous generations, they want something like good quality of life. It's not just something expensive, but they want good qualities. Even the luxurious brand, they don't just look for brands. They look for brands that have its own features, its solid uniqueness. So of course, for instance, they value more classic brands like Chanel, like Dior, but nowadays they also embrace brands like D&G, Givenchy, Gucci is kind of like polarizing, you know, between people. I think they want to buy something that makes them feel better because they value individualism. They value the idea of fast because of internet, right? They want to be efficient. They want to buy products that will help them to make their life more easier and convenient and look good. Yeah.
And do you see this as just a passing phase, or how do you see Generation Z evolving as they become older, they start their own families, they become the main consumers in China?
These Generation Z, they're only getting their first job right now. So I would think we can allow them a little bit more time to grow, you know, to learn how the whole things work. Of course, they will have their burdens to, you know, to sustain their families and also their grandparents and their parents in the future. But I believe things will move toward a better situation later.
Mm-hmm. Yumin Chen, thank you so much.
Thank you.